Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Study with Soumya. I hope you all are well and safe. Before proceeding further in the video, make sure to subscribe this channel and do like this video. So in this video, we are going to discuss Adobe programming interview question. So make sure to watch the complete video. Also do share this video with your friends. Your support is very much needed, guys. So let's start with the question now. So the question is, given a non-empty singly linked list with the head node head, return a middle node of the linked list. If there are two middle nodes, return the second middle node. Right. So basically, a function is given to you, and the function you have to do that you have to return a middle node of a linked list. Right. So there are two approaches, or basically I should say three approaches to solve the question. I will discuss two important approaches that you can use and that are optimized ones. Right, so you can choose accordingly which approach suits you. So for example, here they have given the example that if the input is 1 2 3 4 5, so suppose these are the values present in our linked list, so the middle element here is going to be this third one, right? This node 3 is going to be the middle element, so that's why in output we have to give this node 3, right? So what should be the first approach? So suppose this is our linked list. Right, so what we can do, first I will tell you about the two pointer approach or hare and tortoise approach. Right, so this is a very common approach to solve this problem. So what we will do here, we know that tortoise walks slowly, whereas hare runs faster. Right, so what we can do, initialize both, let's take two pointers. First one is slow one and the second one is first one. Initialize both of them with head. Right, now what we will do, that this slow one will take one step ahead, one step, and the fast one will move with the double speed, that it will take double step. Right, and when this faster one will move to the end of the linked list, right, or basically I should say that in the next of the linked list is going to be null, or if the fast pointer itself move to the null, in that case the node on which our slow pointer is pointing to is going to be our middle node. Let me explain you with the help of this diagram. So currently slow and fast, both these pointers are pointing to our head node, that is both are pointing to this 5, right? And next what we will do, next what they will do, so the slow will move with one step, that is it will move to 7, but fast will move with the double step, so fast will point to the 3, right? Again, okay, so we have to basically run a loop. We have to check that the loop will run up to the time the fast value is not equal to null, or like in the fast of next we don't have null, so till then we have to run the loop. So here in the fast of next there is no null, also fast is also not on null. Again, this will move by one step, so it will come to this node 3 now, and this will move by double step. So now when we will check the condition that fast is not equal to null, condition is going to be false, because fast this fast one is now pointing to null, right? So just determine, just tell me to which node our slow is pointing to. 3, right? So this is going to our correct answer, this is going to be our middle element. So this is the first approach which we can use to find the middle element of the linked list. So right now the nodes are even, 1 2 3 4. Let me show you the same, taking odd 5. Also in the question itself they have mentioned that if the nodes are even, then you have to return the second node, that is 7 and 3 are the middle one, but we have to return the second. So currently, so this is our head pointing to, so they are also pointing to this slow, and faster also pointing to this first one, right? Now what will happen, slow will move by one step, this is slow moving, and fast will move by double step, so now fast is pointing to 8. Now again slow will move by one step, so it will point to 8, and fast will move to the double step, so now it will point to 12. Right, so here we will check that fast of next not equal to null, but the condition is false, because past of next is pointing to null this time, so the loop will terminate. And now from here what you can see that slow is pointing to 8, and even in the linked list itself you can see that which one is the middle element, 8, right? So 8 is going to our middle node. So this is the hare and tortoise approach. Let me implement the same and then we will discuss the next approach, right? Okay, so let's do the implementation thing. So the problem is given in the LeetCode itself. So we have to, this is our function middle node. So here we have to write the logic or the approach that we just discussed, right? So let's take two pointer, that is fast and slow, and they both are pointing to head first, right? Now we have to check the condition that while fast not equal to none and fast dot next not equal to none. So if this is the case, or like if this condition is true, so what we will do, we will move our slow pointer by one step, right? And we will move our fast pointer by two step, that is next dot next. Right, and after coming out of this loop, the node on which our slow pointer is pointing to is going to be our middle node, right? So just return slow. So yeah, that's it. Let's run our code. Okay, it ran successfully. Let's submit. Yeah, it worked fine. Okay, so this was the first approach. Let us see the next approach now. Okay, so the next approach that I am going to tell you is kind of a logical one, or kind of tricky one I should say. So here, let's suppose there is a pointer that is pointing to head of our linked list, right? And let's take a counter variable, that is C, initialize it with 0. So what you will notice here, that C, when suppose, so here what we will try to do, we will run a loop up to the time our head is not equal to none, or basically null. In Python we say it null. Okay, so we will run this loop and here we will check that if, so see, this is suppose okay, so we will check that if counter variable, that is C, is odd. So you can use either this bitwise end to determine whether C value is odd or even, right? So if you will do this bitwise end between even number and this one, obviously we are going to get 0, 0. But in case of odd, the condition is going to be true. So we will check that if C bitwise end 1, so in that case what we will do, we will move our mid element one step ahead, right? And if this is not the case, we won't do anything, just we will increment the value of our counter variable and we will move our head node ahead, right? So let me tell you, let me just iterate you through the code itself. So first of all, initially the value of counter variable is 0, so 0 and 1 is obviously going to be 0, so this condition is not true. Now so this is 0, now 1, so counter variable is now 1, right? So head is pointing to this node now, okay, because we have moved further. So here if you will check 1 bitwise end 1, it is going to be true, so we will move our mid element, or like mid pointer, one step ahead. So now this is our mid. Initially it is pointing to head, but now it will point to 7, right? Now again C value is incremented, it is going to be 2 this time. So 2 is also even, 2 and this bitwise and 1 is going to give us 0, so this condition is not true. So C is going to be 3 this time, right? And again we will check 3 bitwise and 1 is going to be true, so we will move our middle element one step ahead. So this time again our counter variable is going to be 4, and 4 and bitwise end 1 condition is not true. Now this time this is going to be 5, but also head is going to point to null, right? So we won't move inside the loop now because head not equal to null condition is false, right? So you can see that this mid pointer is pointing to the middle element now, and we can simply return this middle element, and that's it, right? So this is also a kind of tricky approach, and even I was kind of amazed by seeing this approach, so that's why I thought to share the same with you. So I think you understood the approach, and here it is not important that you have to use bitwise, and you can do this simply if c mod 2 not equal to 0. But I have used bitwise and because see, using these sort of operators kind of increase the execution speed, so that is the only thing. Let us implement the same approach. Okay, so let me remove it first. So first we will have a mid pointer that is pointing to head, and next we will have a counter variable, initialize it with 0. So what we will do, while head not equal to none, so in that case we will check that if c ampersand, okay, ampersand 1, if this condition is true, so we will move our mid pointer one step ahead, right? If this is not the case, then just simply increment the value of counter variable and move the head one step ahead, and after coming out of this, just simply return this mid pointer, right, as if this is pointing to the mid node. So let's run our code. It prints successfully. Let's submit. Okay, so it worked fine, and even you can see the performance is kind of good, as if it is 24 milliseconds faster than 95.62% of Python 3 online submissions. That's kind of good. I hope you understood both the approaches. Let me know which approach you think is kind of easy and understandable, right? And if you like the video, do share this video, like this video, do subscribe this channel. Bye bye.